PowerDirector 16, how do we get that film look? You know, the look with the black bars on top and on the bottom. And then you got to color grade it. A lot of what movie producers do is they'll shoot in 24 frames per second, 1080. And there's even, I think they call them logs or something like that, where they make the film actually look kind of like dishwater. And then when you import it, you can add LUTs to it, you can color grade it, and you can give it whatever look you want. And that's getting all crazy and professional. What I'm going to do is I'm going to show you how to just get that black bar across the top and the black bar across the bottom so that your videos will look like that movie look. And really, all you need is a graphic that has that. So let me show you what I mean. In this particular video here, this is actually a tornado I went through. And notice the bottom and the top is completely
full. So folks, you're joining us. It's 5:43. A tornado warning. Tornado warning.
Okay, is what's going on here. And I actually have that video over on my Secret Stuff channel if you want to watch it. It's pretty long, actually, when we went through a tornado warning. But here's the image, and you can't really see it here, but I'll have a link to it in the bottom. And you'll see right off the bat, I got the lines on the bottom, the lines on the top. All it has is a line across the top and a line across the bottom, and the middle is see-through. That's it. You can make it in your own paint shop program if you want, or like I said, you can go to that link there and go pick it up. So I'll bring that all the way down. And you'll kind of see that the links are there, but I'll go into Fix and Enhance. And I have Color Director, but you can go into Color Enhancement if you don't. Okay, so we can actually go up and down if we want. Or I can go into Color Adjustment, and I can play with these. Or I could go into some more lighting. You see, I could bring the lighting up on it. That way makes it somewhat easier to see. I say apply it all. Okay. And I'll turn this down a little bit. And there we have a movie look.
Right now. And have a battery operated radio with you. Have a flashlight in case the rain.
Now I could edit this video and put my logo here in the bottom left. You really don't want to put your logo on the right side because YouTube already allows you to put your logo there. So you might want to put something on the left side. Maybe your signature, whatever. You know, give it a little more pizzazz. But let's have a look at a different one, okay? So maybe you can see it a little bit better. I'm going to bring down a green screen. I'll put that in the middle. I'll cut this out just for demonstration purposes on how to make this movie look. My movie look always goes on the bottom, so keep that in mind. That's where my image goes. Notice the black lines are in there. Bring that across. Okay. And I want to be talking in the study. So I'll pull that up. I'll pull that image way across. So I got an image on the top. I got my movie look image on the bottom. And then, of course, I got to green screen this. I do have a video on that. I'll post that in the link there so you can actually go see how to green screen. So no need to me to dolly on this. I can move pretty quick. And we'll say okay on that. And there we go. We've got our we got our video where it looks like that
in the bottom. See? You can check that out. Maybe use all
my
three.
Green screened a bit too much, but you know.
But one thing is for sure, if you're not.
So not too bad, not too bad. So what you need is basically that image. And you'll pretty much be good to go then.
You're not making thumbnails. You're not ranking.
Now, I'll go into a little depth here of the green screen that I'm running and some pitfalls. I'll have the links in the bottom to the ones I bought if you're interested. And I bought a kit and the green screen itself was too thin. And literally the kit is awesome. I mean, it came with the poles, everything I needed, but the actual green screen was just too thin. It just wouldn't do it right. So I had to go back and buy a separate, just a green screen that was really thick. And that made it a lot nicer. And at the same time, I couldn't get the green screen taut enough. So I had to buy some special clips to actually clip on it and pull that green screen nice and taut. And when I did that, it's awesome, as you can see. The green screen look comes out really, really, really nice. So I'll have everything there that I bought that I have set up that if you want, you can go pick it up on Amazon yourself. But this is a movie look. You need the image. Again, the link will be in the bottom for that image if you want to go buy it. Or you can make it in your own paint program yourself. But that's how they're doing basically the movie look on YouTube. And there's a lot more into this where, like I was saying, you're recording 24 frames per second. And you can do lots of searching on YouTube on how to set up your camera. And everybody's camera is different, whether you're running a Canon 80D or, you know, a point-and-shoot camera or even a phone. Every camera is different. So you really need to look up that information on your specific camera on other people that have done, given the reviews and information on how to do that. So here's how you do a movie look in PowerDirector 16. At the same time, I've applied it to a tornado that we had come through and actual green screen effect. And I'll try to remember to have all the links at the bottom for everything I've talked about, even the video for the tornado that was coming in if you want to watch that. But here's how you do a movie look in PowerDirector 16. And I'll catch you guys on the next one.